Hi, and welcome back to our e-telecast, God Has a Word for You, and I'm Pastor Aminata. And I'm excited. I am overwhelmed with this joy. Just talking about the whole topic of joy. And remember, our theme is, what is joy, or understanding the purpose of joy. And just to backtrack real quick so that we can find out where we are, starting with Galatians 5:22, we understand that when we allow the Holy Spirit to control our lives, it will produce in us joy. Because joy is not something that I can generate. Joy is not something that you can create on your own. But it's a gift that comes from God. But there's a purpose for this joy. And then we also came to learn that Jesus himself, all right, understood. And going back to Hebrews, where it says that he, Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, for the joy that was set before him, all right, endured the cross, despising the shame. Mm-mm. And so what was that joy? That joy was you and I. That was the joy. That's what had him excited, and better yet, that's what he focused on. And I can see now and understand how we need to now tap into that joy for strength. Because it's God's joy. When I feel like I can't make it, tap into that joy for strength. And we left off where Jesus was teaching his disciples. And he was giving them instruction. And St. John's, the 14th chapter. And he says, you've not done this before. But he says, anything you ask in my name, you will receive it, so that your joy may be full. See, Jesus understood what it's going to take in order for us to walk this Christian walk. And believe it or not, you're going to need joy in order to do it. I bet you haven't thought about that. I know I didn't. But you really are going to need joy to get you through the hard places. You're going to need joy to get you through those trying times. You're going to need joy when you're tested. You're going to need joy when you're persecuted. You're going to need that joy. So, as like I said, because we are learning how to become and how to be disciples of Christ, let's go back now and listen to Jesus as he speaks. We're going to John, the 15th chapter now. And in the 15th chapter, you know, Jesus is talking about he's the true vine, all right? And his Father is the farmer, but he's the vine, but we are the branches. And it is our responsibility to produce what? Fruit. There it is. But how can we produce the fruit? We cannot produce any fruit unless we are connected to the vine, and that vine is Jesus. And you will find that in John 15, starting where he says in verse 5, and it says right here, he says, yes, I'm the vine, and you are the branches, and those who remain in me and I in them will produce much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. See, again, remember, going back to Galatians, all right, the fruit of the Spirit, the evidence. He says that it's our responsibility to produce it, but that's if we are in right relation with Christ. There's your evidence right there. Because if you are walking in right relationship, if your relationship is right and if it's tight, you will be bearing fruit. But let's go down to verse 8. Verse 8, it says, my true disciples produce much fruit, and this brings great glory to my Father. He says, my true disciples. Now, let that resonate for a minute. My true disciples, meaning there's probably other disciples that are not true, because the true disciples are going to be producing much fruit in their lives. They will be producing the fruit that they have allowed the Holy Spirit to have control over, and the Holy Spirit will generate that fruit. Let's go down to verse 10. Verse 10 says, when you obey me, you remain in my love, just as I obey my Father and remain in his love. So Jesus, once again, is letting us know. See, when we obey him, we remain in his love. We remain in right relationship with him, just as he obeyed his Father and remained in his love. You don't need people trying to operate outside the zone, all right? People that, you know, got it in their own minds. This is the way it should be. He's the one that does the directing. All we got to do is follow him. He said, if any man will be one of my disciples, let him let go of his own selfish ambition, shoulder his own cross, and follow me. So, in other words, you do as I do. And if I can tap into my joy, I need you to tap into my joy. All right? Not your joy, his joy. If Jesus can tap into his joy, then he wants us to tap into his joy as well. But let's go down to verse 11. I want to read that as well. John 15:11. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full. And so once again, all right, he is letting us know. He has said these things so that his joy, praise God, will remain in us. And that our joy in him will be full. And we then can go out and be about our Father's business. We can go out and be bold soldiers. We can go out and it doesn't matter what comes at us, because we're going to have the joy of the Lord to hang in there with. That's one of the purposes of joy. And so, again, all we have to remind ourselves is, what did Jesus have? What did he use? And if this is what he used, it's good enough for me. It should be good enough for you. The joy of Jesus Christ, so that his joy in us may be full. This is what he says to us, and we are his disciples. As he spoke this to his disciples then, he's speaking to his disciples now. And I'm going to come back, because we got a lot more to cover. Y'all hang with us, okay? Pastor Aminata, what is the purpose of joy? God has a word for you.
If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you're sincere and that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says in Romans chapter 10 that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and I need God in my life. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God who went to the cross to wash away my sin. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, I want you to email us and let us know, because right now, you're saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and pray that God would lead you to a Bible-believing church where you can continue to grow in grace. God bless you.